But I said in the last part of the film that I would talk about some of the compromises we've had to make with the packing and how that is not necessarily working as well as it might for us. Hello and welcome to another episode of Wolfie's Wheels. This is part two of the long journey around various parts of Europe, principally going from the UK to the Czech Republic, to go to Prague, then across to Budapest, or down to Budapest, and then back up to Vienna. So it's basically Prague, Budapest, Vienna being the tour highlights. So in part two of this film, I will reiterate it's not somebody else's holiday snaps, and it isn't. And just for information, we're by the banks of the Moselle in some town in Germany. But I said in the last part of the film that I would talk about some of the compromises we've had to make with the packing and how that is not necessarily working as well as it might for us. So I'll just show you what the problem is. So normally, you see these ramps here travel in the boot, which is actually under the bed here and accessed from barn doors, but we've had to put them inside the van instead. And also we've got this chair here, which is travelling in the van as well, and that would normally be under the bed as well, but with the bikes in there, that's a bit of an issue. On the bed we've got the silver screens, which basically travel there anyway, so the silver screens being on the bed to travel is not a problem. But what's not working for us really is that we've got one chair in the van and one chair in the under the bed storage, which you can't really get to because of how the bikes are packed in. So we're going to have to, when we get on site, review the packing. Because the other thing as well, of course, is the ramps. While we're using the ramps if at night, it's fine, but we've stopped a couple of times already and we haven't had to use the ramps. And they've gone in this area here, you know, when we've got the seats turned. This is Anne sat beautifully waiting for me patiently. But anyway, so they're sort of out of the way, but it's a little bit inconvenient because that's also where the silver screens will live if we haven't been putting them on, which we tend not to do if we're only staying for one night. But anyway, that's it for now. I just thought I'd just reintroduce the film and talk about some of the compromises in the packing. And tonight when we get on site, we're going to have a reshuffle of the packing, I think. If the rain ever stops, because we've had two beautiful days and it's raining. So we just need to sort that out anyway. Anyway, I will speak later. Okay, I mentioned the compromises with the packing and the way stuff has to be transported in the van. But I thought I'd just show you sort of the problems it can cause us at the moment when you're stopped. It's just a bit chaotic. The ramps sort of have to live just here in the footwell, and then you've got the silver screens and shoes and all sorts of rubbish, and it just makes it a bit untidy really. I mean, it's not a huge problem, but if the ramps here are in use, then obviously they're not in the van and it's not a problem. If the silver screens are in use, they're on there and that's not a problem. But currently where we are here in Rüdesheim next to the Rhine in Germany, we have no need to use the ramps because it's a level site and it's not hot, so we don't need the silver screens on to keep the van cool during the day, and it's not cold, so we don't need them on to keep it cool at night. So as I say, they're just sort of floating about, but that is sort of a bit of a downside of a smaller van. But very much on the plus side of what makes a van like this really good for touring, apart from the real ease of driving. I mean, we did about a 7-hour drive yesterday and it's just absolutely fine. In fact, I did all the driving, we had a couple of stops. But as I mentioned earlier, it's a really easy thing to drive. But one of the things that makes it really good for touring firstly, the small table. So you can almost immediately set yourself up to have something to eat. And of course the fixed bed at the back, which means really you have no messing about every day. You know, the bed, you get up, you just put the bed covers over like you would at home, you arrive on site and the bed's ready done to get into, so there's none of this messing about of moving different cushions around and getting sleeping bags or duvets out of the storage, blah blah blah. And that really is so super helpful. Okay, it's only a two-berth van and the rest of it, but for two people, it really does work well. Very, very happy with the layout and how it's working out on sort of a tour where we're here and there just for the odd night.
It really is easy to get the table just in here in the wardrobe. The leg stows neatly in this side of the wardrobe. And if we come down here and introduce you here to Colin, the knitted greyhound that we won in a raffle once, comes everywhere with us. The table top just lives down there. So you simply have to pull this top out, which I can't do with one hand, but believe me, it comes out really easily. Back out of the wardrobe, and Bob's your uncle, you know. I'll just set it very quickly up and see sort of where it goes. And there you have the table up. So I sit here, and Anne sits there, and it's perfectly big enough for two people to have their dinner on. And of course, you've got this other flappage bit here, which is useful for putting your cups on, because okay, it is a slightly small table, and if you've got your cups of tea or whatever on the table as well, they are at risk of being knocked over while you're scoffing your tea. And generally, when we're on site, we don't bother putting the table away. We just sort of hoof it into the footwell with the general melee of stuff. But actually, you know, if this silver screens are on and the ramps are in use, it's not a problem. But it just saves putting it away and getting it out every few minutes or a few times a day.
The advantage of the fixed bed, so not only do you not make your bed up every night, but during the day we just use it as sort of a flat surface dumping ground. But actually, while we're just looking at the bed, I'll just show you this bit here, where we put two storage panels on the side of the bed, so you can put stuff like hankies and your phone in this one and what have you. And that isn't actually fitted as normal in the Auto Sleeper Kingham. This is just a plain drawer, but these two pockets were actually fitted to this outside bit here, so they were screwed on there, which is sort of a bit weird really. I suppose if you sat outside, then you could use it as a magazine rack, but we never did. So we just took them off there, and it suits our needs better with them being sort of down there and useful at night. Currently we're in transit, and we're heading over to Nuremberg, which is about 100 odd kilometers away now. We've diverted off of the main road because of some roadworks, but I thought, I've mentioned before about how relaxing it is to be in the van, and what a good thing it is for touring around in. Now, we're driving along at the moment, we're doing about 52, 53 miles an hour, which is the speed limit on this road, and hopefully it's coming out in the sound, just how quiet overall the van is. I mean, there's not really any rattles or squeaks or anything like that. Certainly not now I've sorted that microwave out. There's a little bit of noise coming from the roof fence up there, just there. But other than that, all is good. I mean, it's a manual gearbox van. It's a manual gearbox van, and the gear lever's just there, and it's really handy. I don't know if Anne just wants to just demonstrate by changing down and then back up. It's so close to the steering wheel, it's just a non-issue. You probably can't see from there, but the mileage, average fuel consumption since we set off on this journey is 35.5 to the gallon. So it's a really economical van as well. 5.5 to the gallon has sort of been achieved, driving at speeds that actually we want to drive at. So it's not that we've ever driven this van in such a way to say, oh, we must go a bit slower because we want to save fuel. Okay, we haven't flown along, we're on holiday, but I mean, it shows you the sort of fuel consumption you can reasonably expect on a long trip in a van like this, which has got 11,446 miles on us on recording this. Anyway, I thought I'd just put a little bit in about what it's like and how noisy or otherwise it is to drive. I'm not going to disturb Anne because she is driving, and it's raining, and we're on unknown routes, and that's it. And the traffic's just about to stop. There you go. Right, okay, that's it for now.
Well, here we are today in Prague, en route. I think the next stop after this is Brno, and then we go down to Budapest. But in this little section of film, we're actually here for 3 nights. So we camp in a slightly different way compared with how we have been when we're just sort of doing 1 night. As you can see, we've put the silver screens on the outside. Now these are really good for not only keeping it warm at night, but keeping it cool in the day. A bit more privacy, but that's sort of an aside, to be honest. But they're on there, so we put them on. And as you can see, we've put the wind-out awning out and the mat down. As ever, we generally use the storm straps, which you can see here, on the awning, just to make sure it's tethered down. And these wind blockers are really, really good. I mean, it has really transformed how we camp when we're away for a bit longer, because it makes the outside space completely usable, which it didn't necessarily used to be. So, you know, a couple of chairs, you know, you can sit outside, even if it's a little bit breezy, you know the awning's not going anywhere. And of course, one advantage of putting all the stuff outside there, which don't forget is carried in this smallish, relatively small camper van thing. Well, one of the advantages is that inside now we've got a lot more space down in this footwell area. You know, we've just got the cover for the silver screens. So I'm just going to wrap this section of the film up at this point. I think it's probably long enough. Before I do, just a couple of stats. So far we've come about 1211 miles since we left home. We've averaged 35.5 to the gallon, which is surprisingly good. I thought we might get about 30-32, so 35 and a bit's really good. And been driving on the road for a total of 30 and a bit hours. I hope you enjoyed this video. I look forward to seeing you in the next one. If you did like it, please feel free to share it and tell your mates, and don't forget to subscribe, and you can even put the bell icon and let anyone know when the next films are coming out. That's it for now, and I'll see you in the next episode of A Wolf Is Wheels. Bye.